स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ दीपक एंड वेलकम टू माई चैनल दीपक बायोलॉजी क्लास। तो फ्रेंड, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द क्रोमेटोग्राफी एंड द टाइप्स ऑफ क्रोमेटोग्राफी। ओके, सो बिफोर गोइंग टू द टाइप्स ऑफ क्रोमेटोग्राफी, लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट द क्रोमेटोग्राफी। सो वॉट इज क्रोमेटोग्राफी? सो क्रोमेटोग्राफी, इट इज अ बेसिक टेक्निक थ्रू विच वी कैन सेपरेट द कंपोनेंट्स और द मॉलिक्यूल फ्रॉम द मिक्सचर। ओके, सो क्रोमेटोग्राफी इट इज अ टेक्निक विच इन्वॉल्व्स द सेपरेशन ऑफ कंपोनेंट्स और मॉलिक्यूल्स फ्रॉम द मिक्सचर। ओके, सो इन द क्रोमेटोग्राफी टेक्निक इट इन्वॉल्व्स टू इंपॉर्टेंट फेजेस। द फर्स्ट वन इज मोबाइल फेज एंड अनदर वन इज स्टेशनरी फेज। ओके, एंड दिस मोबाइल फेज एंड स्टेशनरी फेज एंड द इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन दिस मोबाइल फेज एंड स्टेशनरी फेज, इट रिजल्ट्स इन द सेपरेशन ऑफ द कंपोनेंट्स फ्रॉम द मिक्सर। सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, दिस इज अ स्टेशनरी फेज, स्टेशनरी फेज, and this stationary phase, it may be solid or liquid. Okay, so the other one is mobile phase. Okay, suppose this is one mobile phase. So stationary phase, जैसा कि नाम से आपको लग रहा है कि it is stagnant in nature, means it is stagnant in nature, means it can't move. Okay, on the other hand, if we talk about the mobile phase, so mobile phase, तो जैसे नाम से लग रहा है कि मोबाइल फेज, यानी कि इट मूवमेंट होगा इसमें, ठीक है। तो मोबाइल फेज में क्या होता है कि सॉल्यूशन कैन मूव। ओके, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड द मोबाइल फेज। सो क्रोमेटोग्राफी टेक्निक इट इन्वॉल्व्स टू इंपॉर्टेंट फेजेस। द फर्स्ट वन इज स्टेशनरी फेज एंड द अनदर वन इज मोबाइल फेज। ओके, सो नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रिंसिपल। ओके, सो प्रिंसिपल of chromatography is dependent on the stationary phase and the mobile phase, and when the interaction between stationary phase and the mobile phase takes place, then the molecules get separated, or we can say that the component gets separated. Okay, so now we'll see about principle. Okay, so as I mentioned that it involves stationary and mobile phase. The mobile phase refers to the mixture of substances that need to be separate, and these molecules or the component get dissolved in either gas or in liquid. Okay, and the stationary phase is a porous solid matrix through which the sample contained in the mobile phase percolates. This interaction between द मोबाइल फेज, मोबाइल एंड स्टेशनरी फेज रिजल्ट्स इन द सेपरेशन ऑफ कंपोनेंट्स फ्रॉम द मिक्सचर. ओके, सो दिस इज द प्रिंसिपल बिहाइंड द क्रोमेटोग्राफी टेक्निक दैट इट इन्वॉल्व स्टेशनरी फेज एज वेल एज द मोबाइल फेज. देन द मोबाइल फेज रिफर्स टू द मिक्सचर ऑफ द सब्सटेंस दैट नीड टू बी सेपरेटेड एंड दिस मॉलिक्यूल्स और द कंपोनेंट गेट डिजॉल्व इन द आइदर इन द गैसेस फॉर्म और वी कैन से इन द लिक्विड फॉर्म. एंड देन द स्टेशनरी फेज रिफर्स टू द सॉलिड पोरस मैट्रिक्स टू विच द सैंपल्स विच कंटेन इन द मोबाइल फेज get percolates and this interaction between the mobile phase and the stationary phase results in the separation of the components or the molecules from the mixture. So this is the principle behind the chromatography technique. So after that, now we will discuss about the types of chromatography. Okay, so next is types of chromatography. So now on the basis of different states, for example, any molecule can present either in the form of solid, liquid or gas. So here we have divided the chromatography types. So the first one is gas chromatography, then liquid chromatography, and the third one is supercritical fluid chromatography. Okay. So in the gas chromatography, the substance or the molecules which are present in the mixture are dissolved in the gas form. Okay, means the molecules or the component which we need to separate are dissolved in the gaseous form. Now in the liquid chromatography, the substance or the molecules or we can say the component which we need to separate get dissolved in the liquid form. Okay, after that come this supercritical fluid chromatography. So this supercritical fluid chromatography, it involves those fluids or we can say those molecules which are neither gas or liquid, means they can show the property of both, means gas and the liquid. Okay, so because of this nature, it is very difficult to deal with all those molecules or we can say supercritical fluids with this gas chromatography or liquid chromatography. And these fluids, they mostly occur at a critical temperature or we can say critical pressure. Okay, so these supercritical fluid, they occur if the critical temperature and the critical pressure is above. Okay, for example, there are some many molecules or we can say gases. For example, if you talk about the liquid nitrogen. Okay, so nitrogen, it exits as a in the gas form. Okay, but by applying the temperature as well as different pressure which is specific for that particular gas, then we can liquefy that gas. Okay, so for example, if we take the example of water, okay, if we take the example of water, H2O, ठीक है, so suppose this is a test tube, so we will take three condition, okay, and there water molecule is present, okay, so normally at 25 degree centigrade, and then we will take 100 degree centigrade condition. And then 373 degree centigrade condition. Okay, so as we can see that at 25 degree centigrade the water will be in liquid form. Okay, in liquid form. And at 100 degree centigrade what happen? Boiling occurs. Okay, then water will get start evaporating. Okay, but the water will still be in the liquid form. Okay, so these are temperature which is below the critical temperature, means because of that the water is in liquid form, it is not evaporating. But if we talk about 370 degree centigrade, equal to or greater than, okay, greater than 373 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, देन द वी कांट सी द वॉटर मॉलिक्यूल्स इन द लिक्विड फॉर्म. सो वॉटर हेयर द वॉटर विल बी इन द वेपर फॉर्म. ओके, वॉटर विल नॉट बी इन द लिक्विड फॉर्म, इट विल बी इन द वेपर फॉर्म. सो दिस इज अ क्रिटिकल टेम्परेचर एट विच द वॉटर विल प्रेजेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वेपर. ओके, सो दीज आर द क्रिटिकल फ्रूट्स, आर दोज फ्रूट्स विच अगर इफ द which occur if the critical temperature and the critical pressure is above the normal temperature and normal pressure. Okay, so for example, अगर इसका example देखें तो CO2 and water, these are the two molecules which are supercritical fluid. Okay, or if we do this supercritical fluid chromatography, then this CO2, it acts as a mobile phase. Okay, it acts as a mobile phase. So because of that, we can't deal these supercritical fluids either with gas chromatography or the liquid chromatography. Okay, but the technique for separating this supercritical fluid, special techniques are required. Or okay, and this technique, they are very costly. Okay, and their sensitivity is high. So because of that, these supercritical fluid chromatography, we need some other type of techniques, or we can say some special technique for separating these fluids. Okay, so now we will discuss about the gas chromatography, liquid chromatography, and the, so mostly we discuss gas chromatography and liquid chromatography. This supercritical fluid chromatography we will discuss later. Okay, so in the gas chromatography, it is of two types. The first one is gas and liquid chromatography. Okay, so whatever the mixture we want to separate, or we can say whatever the molecules or the component we want to separate, here these components or the mixture, it dissolves in the form of gas. Okay, so the first one is gas liquid chromatography. Okay, so as I mentioned that for separating any component, it required two different phases. The first one is mobile phase and the another one is stationary phase. Okay, so in gas liquid chromatography, the mobile phase is gas. Okay, because all the molecules which we need to separate are present in the gaseous form. So obviously the mobile phase will be gas. And in case of stationary phase will be liquid. Okay, so after that, the next one is gas and the solid chromatography. Again, the mobile phase will be gas, because here the molecules which we want to separate is dissolved in the gaseous form. Okay, because of that, the mobile phase will be only gas. And here the stationary phase will be solid. Okay, so now we talk about the liquid chromatography. So in liquid chromatography, there are many other chromatography. It involves like the HPLC, size exclusion chromatography, ion exchange chromatography, paper chromatography, and thin layer chromatography. Okay, so in HPLC, like the name indicates, it's a high performance liquid chromatography, or we can say the high pressure liquid chromatography. Okay, so in HPLC, the mobile phase will be liquid, as the name indicates, because all the molecules which we need to separate are dissolved in the liquid form. And then the stationary phase will be solid, or the bonded phase. Okay, so in HPLC, what happens? The molecules are present in the aqueous phase. Okay, so it is of aqueous type. Okay, or we can say the molecules which we need to separate are present in the aqueous form. So in this technique, normally a solvent moves with a high pressure, as the name indicates, na, high pressure liquid chromatography. So the solvent moves with a high pressure, and then the molecules which are present are get adsorbed on the surface of solid stationary phase. So iska jo mode of principle ho gaya, wo kya ho gaya? Adsorption. Okay, means the molecules get adsorbed, means adsorbed on the surface of solid stationary phase. Okay, and it requires a high pressure. That's why it is also sensitive and costly. Okay, and the solvent, mostly it moves through a column, and this column is consist of some solid stationary phase. Okay, so as the pressure applies, then this solvent moves very fast with a high pressure, and the molecules which need to be separated get adsorbed on the solid stationary phase. So this is about the HPLC and the principle. Basic principle. In the coming videos, I will discuss about separate chromatography types, and I will then teach you that how this HPLC works. So wait for the कमिंग अपकमिंग वीडियोस. सो नेक्स्ट इन एचपीएलसी एज आई मेंशन मोबाइल फेज विल बी लिक्विड एंड एचपीएलसी फेज विल बी सॉलिड ऑन द फाउंडर फेज. नेक्स्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द साइज एक्सक्लूजन क्रोमेटोग्राफी. सो एज द नेम इंडिकेट साइज मीन्स द मॉलिक्यूल्स विच वी हैव टू सेपरेट आर गेट सेपरेटेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूलर साइज. बिकॉज इसमें क्या है साइज एक्सक्लूजन क्रोमेटोग्राफी है मीन्स जो मॉलिक्यूल्स हैं उनके साइज की बेस पे क्या हो रहा है कि जो मॉलिक्यूल्स हो रहे हैं वो सेपरेट हो रहे हैं एक दूसरे से. ओके इफ यू टेक द एग्जाम्पल फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस इज द फर्स्ट कंडीशन दिस इज द सेकेंड वन This is the third one. Okay. So, suppose this is stationary phase and you can see the column consists of some solid bead. ठीक है अब इसका column है इसको किसका बना होता है stationary phase का it may be dextron or we can say some agarose gel. Okay so and this is a mixture of different substances. Okay, so for suppose these are three conditions. Okay, so this is a stationary phase. Okay, stationary phase, or we can say solid matrix. Okay, and these are the molecules which we need to be separated. Okay, so it is a mobile phase. Mobile phase. Okay, so what happens? The molecules which are larger in size, okay, the molecules which are larger in size, then they will elute first as compared to the molecules which are smaller in size. For example, here you can see in the third phase, this is the first one, this is second one, and this is third one. So you can see in the third one that these larger molecules, which is having greater size, ओके, दीज एल्यूट फर्स्ट एंड देन द स्मॉलर मॉलिक्यूल्स दे गेट स्टक और डिफ्यूज इन दिस सॉलिड बीड्स. ओके, सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट दीज मॉलिक्यूल्स, दीज स्मॉल मॉलिक्यूल्स दे टेक लॉन्गर टाइम एंड दे ट्रेवल मच लार्जर डिस्टेंस एज कंपेयर टू द लार्ज मॉलिक्यूल्स. ओके, सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट दीज लार्ज मॉलिक्यूल्स व्हाट हैपन, दे एल्यूट फर्स्ट एज वी कंपेयर टू द दिस स्मॉलर मॉलिक्यूल्स. ओके, सो दिस इज अबाउट द साइन एक्सक्लूजन क्रोमेटोग्राफी. सो इन मोबाइल फेज इट विल बी लिक्विड एंड द स्टेशनरी फेज इट विल बी अ सॉलिड मैट्रिक्स और वी कैन से द कॉलम विच इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ सम सॉलिड बीड्स. ओके, एंड दिस मे बी बिकॉज मे बी ऑफ डेक्स्ट्रॉन और वी कैन से द सम एग्रोल जेल. ओके, दिस इज अ बेसिक अबाउट द साइन एक्सक्लूजन क्रोमेटोग्राफी एंड हाउ दिस प्रिंसिपल वर्क. ओके, नाउ वील टॉक अबाउट द आयन एक्सचेंज क्रोमेटोग्राफी. ओके, सो in ion exchange chromatography the mobile phase will be a liquid and the stationary phase will be a ion exchange resin. okay, so jaisa ki aapko naam se lag raha ion exchange means ion ka exchange ho raha hai. ab kisme ho raha hai, there are only two stages, there are two phases are there, the mobile phase and the stationary phase. so there is a exchange of ion which takes place between the mobile phase and the stationary phase. okay, suppose in mobile phase the molecules or the ions which is present in the aqueous solution get replaced by the ions which are present in the stationary phase or we can say which are present on the resin, it get replaced, but the polarity of these ions will be same, there will be a no difference in the polarity, the polarity will be same, only the ions will get exchanged. And this ion exchange chromatography we can study in two types. First one is anion exchange chromatography and the another one is cation exchange chromatography. ठीक है, तो इन द कमिंग वीडियो वी विल स्टडी वन वन क्रोमेटोग्राफी टाइप्स. ओके, नाउ कमिंग टू द पेपर क्रोमेटोग्राफी. सो दिस पेपर क्रोमेटोग्राफी इट इन्वॉल्व पार्टीशन. ओके, इट इन्वॉल्व पार्टीशन. ओके, सो इन पेपर क्रोमेटोग्राफी द मोबाइल फेज ऑब्वियसली इट विल बी अ लिक्विड एंड देन स्टेशनरी फेज विल बी अ पेपर और वी कैन से द स्ट्रिप ऑफ पेपर बिकॉज पेपर इट इज मेड अप ऑफ सेलुलोज एंड सम वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स आर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन द पेपर. ओके, so in paper chromatography what happens normally, if suppose you have taken some plant extract, theek hai, suppose this is a plant extract, okay, it is a plant extract, suppose spinach, okay, so in paper chromatography this paper paper, okay, then about 2 cm we put a sample, suppose here we keep sample. Okay, so in paper chromatography and thin layer chromatography one thing is common, like in those, in both paper chromatography and thin layer chromatography we use the sample which is dry, means the sample we will dry the sample. Okay, so if suppose we have taken this plant extract, so with the help of capillary tube, okay, this is a capillary tube, okay, so with the help of this capillary tube we will take the sample and then we will place above the 2 cm. okay, after that we will place in the in the paper chromatography chamber and then hang this paper with in the, and then this paper will be hanged in the chromatography chamber. Okay, then we will fill the solution, or we can say here we will use the organic solvent, it may be distilled water or we can say it may be some ethanol, okay, or we can say isopropyl alcohol. Okay, so in this we fill the solvent, organic solvent. Okay, so here it should be below this sample, otherwise the sample will get and it will mix in the organic solvent. Okay, then the whole process will be waste. Okay, so after that what happened, then you just hang on the chromatographic paper, chromatographic chamber, then slowly as the time will pass, then this molecule it gets separated, or we can say the sample it gets separated. So suppose like that, the one component, two component, थ्री कंपोनेंट एंड देन फोर कंपोनेंट एंड दिस वन विल बी अ सॉल्वेंट. ओके सो अप टू दिस पॉइंट द सॉल्वेंट मूव्ड. सॉल्वेंट मूव्ड. ओके सो दिस सैंपल इट गेट सेपरेटेड इनटू वेरियस वेरियस कंपोनेंट्स. ओके डिपेंडिंग ऑन द इंटरेक्टिव नेचर ऑफ द सब्सटेंस और द सैंपल विद द स्टेशनरी फेज. ओके सो सपोज दिस इज क्लोरोफिल बी, दिस इज क्लोरोफिल ए, दिस इज जेंथोफिल एंड दिस इज कैरोटोनाइड्स. ओके सो व्हाट यू हैव सीन दैट विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस ऑर्गेनिक सॉल्वेंट और मोबाइल फेज द सैंपल विच वी कैप्ट इट गेट सेपरेटेड इनटू अ वेरियस वेरियस कंपोनेंट्स. ओके सो क्लोरोफिल ए, क्लोरोफिल बी, जेंथोफिल एंड कैरोटोनाइड्स. ओके so after that we can calculate the distance with the help of retention factor. One factor is there that is called RF. So RF is equal to kya hai? Distance traveled by solute divided by distance traveled by solvent. ओके तो इसे कैसे निकालते हैं. अब सपोज ये जो इतना डिस्टेंस है सॉल्वेंट का, अब सपोज इट इज 15 सेंटीमीटर. ओके तो एंड द अब हम क्लोरोफिल की बात करें, अगर सपोज इट इज 4 सेंटीमीटर मीन सैंपल से लेके यहां तक का इसने डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल किया 4 सेंटीमीटर. ओके तो 4 डिवाइडेड बाय 15 तो इट विल बी अराउंड 0.2 it will be around 0.26 centimeter. Okay, or we can say the retention factor will be a 0.26 and this retention factor it should be between 0 to 1, not below 0 or we can say not above 1. Okay, so this is a basic technique that how this propel chromatography it works. Okay, now if we talk about this thin layer chromatography. Thin layer chromatography. So thin layer chromatography it is also similar to the paper chromatography, but here in the stationary phase we will use silica as a stationary phase. Okay, along with that silica we can use some other components also like the alumina or we can say the cellulose. Okay, so we can use these components also as a stationary phase. Okay, so in thin layer chromatography what happens, there is a glass of sheet, okay, or we can say sheet of glass, okay, and then in that sheet silica gel has been coated, okay, and then it is placed in the solvent and then the separation of the components will start. Okay, so it is almost similar to the paper chromatography, but the main thing is that in stationary phase it will be a silica, okay, and the mobile phase is liquid. Okay, so this is a introduction about the chromatography and the types of chromatography, like it is of two types, like gas chromatography, liquid chromatography, supercritical fluid chromatography. Okay, then the types of chromatography, like the gas chromatography, it is of gas liquid chromatography, gas solid chromatography, and the liquid chromatography, it is further divided into HPLC, size exclusion chromatography, ion exchange chromatography, paper chromatography, thin layer chromatography. So this is a basic introduction about the chromatography and the types of chromatography. Okay, so if you like the video then please share it, and if you are new to my channel then please subscribe it. So in the further lecture we will talk about the single types of chromatography, like the HPLC first, then size exclusion chromatography, like that. Okay, thank you very much.